Hello, it's Missy. Thank you for watching. For today's video, I wanted to do an updo using the woven braid. This is a braid that I figured out how to do a long time ago. It's one of my very favorite braids. So let me know what you think down below in the comment section. If you're new, make sure to subscribe, click that bell as always, and let's get started. With my hair parted on the right side, I'm going to first divide out a section of hair next to the part on the left side and split this into three pieces for my braid. I'm beginning a regular braid by crossing both side strands once over the middle strand. Now I'm going to take the back strand and bring this over my head. Then I'm going to pick up a new section of hair from behind the braid and cross it over the middle strand in place of this dropped piece. Then I'm going to cross the front strand over the middle, pick up a new section and cross it into the middle strand as well. Now instead of crossing the back strand into the braid, I'm going to drop it down and take the previously dropped piece and cross it into the middle section in its place. I also want to add in extra hair similar to a French braid, so I'm picking up a new section of hair from behind the braid and crossing this into the braid as well. Then I'm crossing the French strand over the middle and picking up a new section of hair, crossing it into the braid like a French braid style. Now I'm going to drop down the back strand and replace it with the back strand that I previously clipped away. It's crossing underneath the dropped piece and then into the middle section of the braid. Then I'm picking up a new section of hair and crossing it into the middle strand as well. So I'm crossing the front strand over the middle, picking up a new section of hair, and crossing it into the braid. Now I'm going to drop down the back strand, pick up the previously dropped piece, and cross it over into the middle strand. Then I'm going to divide off a new section of hair and incorporate it into the braid as well. I get a lot of comments that this is a four-strand braid, but it's actually done differently, and if you see the braids side by side, they aren't the same and they do look different. So I'm doing the front side of the braid exactly like a French braid, crossing the side strand into the middle, picking up a new section of hair and bringing it into the braid, crossing it into the middle as well. With the back side of the braid, however, I'm going to interchange two pieces and they're going to weave over each other while also incorporating a new section of hair into the braid as well. So I'm taking the back strand and I'm going to drop it down, take the previous back strand that was clipped up and cross it into the middle of the braid like a regular braid, pick up a new section of hair and bring it into the braid as well. And the previous back strand is going to be clipped up and brought in on the next stitch of the braid. So I'm crossing the front strand over the middle, picking up a new section and bringing it into the middle of the braid as well. Then I'm going to drop down the back strand because it's going to come in on the next stitch. I'm going to take the previously dropped back piece, bring it into the braid, pick up a new section and cross it into the middle section of the braid as well, and clip away the previous back strand to use on the next stitch of the braid. Once the braid reaches the top of my ear, I'm going to stop adding in extra pieces of hair and continue the pattern of the braid, working my way down near the bottom of the section. Then I'm going to slide a bobby pin over the ends so it doesn't unravel. Now I'm going to repeat the same steps and create another braid on the right side of my head. So I'm dividing off a section of hair and splitting it into three pieces for my braid. I'm crossing the side strands over the middle for the initial stitch of the braid. I'm going to do a regular French braid, crossing the side strand into the middle, picking up a new section and crossing it into the middle of the braid as well. On the back side of the braid, I'm going to start interweaving the two sections. So I'm going to first drop down the back strand, then I'm going to pick up a new back strand and cross it over, bringing it into the middle of the braid in its place. Then on the next stitch of the braid, I'm going to drop down the back strand, take the previously clipped away piece, and cross it into the braid so it's in the center, like a regular braid. Pick up a new section of hair and bring this in as well. And then I'm going to clip away the hanging piece to bring into the braid on the next stitch. And I'm going to continue this pattern, working my way down to my ear. And then I'm going to stop adding in additional pieces of hair and just braid the hair down to the bottom. Then I'm going to slide a bobby pin over the ends so it doesn't unravel. Once both braids are done, I'm going to tie the rest of my hair into a low bun. So I'm going to combine all of my hair together, including the two braids, and I'm going to slide a hair band down the ponytail until it's about 3/4 of the way down. Then I'm going to twist all of the hair and the hairband once around my left hand, and then grip the base of the bun with my left hand and wrap the hairband once more over all of the hair to form a knot style bun. Now I'm going to loop and tuck any shorter pieces that are sticking out and use some bobby pins to help pin down any loose flyaway pieces. Then I'm going to use a firm hold hairspray to make the style a little more sleek and polished. Thank you so much for watching. That wraps up today's video. Let me know what you think about this hairstyle down below in the comment section. Also, let me know what you think about this braid versus a 5-strand braid if you ever try both of them out. I think this one definitely trumps. If you're new, make sure to subscribe, click that bell as always, and I will see you next time.